big part of the house makes me you, mate.
Are you just saying that or
oh my god, do you want to take your tongue from out his asshole?
Ah, why are you getting jealous?
You're the only person that said you didn't miss him. I'll stand by that.
Yeah. Cheeky bastard. You want to say that with a fucking luge in the woods later, person?
Sam looks way too happy. That's definitely not the look of a lad who's been told his bird's necked on with someone else. It's obvious that Chloe hasn't told him. And if she wants their relationship to work, she has to be 100% honest.
You are going to be shocked and amazed. Smell that. Just smell it. How nice.
God, what's that?
That's where my arsehole was.
Oh, you dirty bastard.
But it smells amazing.
Oh, does it smell that nice?
I know, right? And I had a sweaty bum. Sweaty bum. Great. It
smells like flowers.
Life is full of surprises. Who would have thought Nathan's bumhole would smell of flowers?
I don't want to waste any more time in this house. I want to get packed and I want to get out.
All right, come with him.
I've never really been camping before, so I don't know what to bring. But fuck it, I'm just going to bring everything.
I've been messaging this guy called Tommy from Amsterdam, and he's actually beautiful. He's handsome, he's chiseled, and most importantly, he gives me that penis throb. But the only thing is, I haven't actually met him, so there's no way I'm telling these lot about him. Let the camping begin, campers!
Let's go camping.
Bye!
Nabby brought two massive suitcases down. Where the fuck do they think they can? The fucking Ritz.
Two, three.
Yes! Yay.
Personally, a night, right? Us lasses, the classy lasses we are, should go for some fancy cocktails.
Oh, God,
that's amazing.
A night on the woos with my two besties sounds a lot better than eating baked beans straight from a tin and shitting in a bush.
Let's talk about the boyfriend. I just want to know where your head's at with it. Like, are you just giving it another go? Are you just taking it quick?
So we just obviously we had a really good talk, and I told him what he needed to change about himself. He told me what I needed to change, and we just said like, we can't leave it.
Relationships are about compromise. I really hope I'm wrong, Chloe, but it seems like exactly the same situation as last time. I just hope she doesn't get hurt again.
I know I'm annoying, like, because I've been saying I'm getting up with him, I'm getting back with him, I'm not getting with him. But then it's so hard when you love someone, like, yeah. You can't just cut them off like that.
And that's, I think, that's where it comes in frustrating for us, because obviously we're your friends. We don't love Sam, so it's a lot harder for us to kind of forgive.
You've seen me cry.
Exactly.
Not being nice. But then there's eight. He's going to only give us advice. And what I say goes, basically. I do see where the girls are coming from, but what they need to realise, me and Sam love each other and we're going to try and make it work, whether anyone likes it or not. At the end of the day, we don't need to speak about him anymore, it's girls' night, we don't need to talk about fucking lads, right?
Yes. I feel like it's going to be a very sophisticated affair.
I agree.
And we should dress like MILFs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Speaking of MILFs, why don't we ring one arms and get one arms out?
Are you serious? That is the best idea in the whole fucking world.
This is going to be the most amazing night. Us girls, with our mams, dressed as mams, with cocktails.
I'm so excited.
I will ring my mam now, and I'll get them to sort it.
Right, go on then.
Amazing.